Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Good Things Come in Small Modules. This video will be all about the Boolean logic module from Hetrick CV. It's a great module for adding crazy and interesting rhythms to your patches, and also a unique way to add some grit to your sounds. Let's start. Okay, so first of all, although this video is about this specific logic module from Hetrick CV, it's actually a video about Boolean logic in general. It's just that this module has many logic gates, so I chose to use this one, but everything I show here will apply also to other modules with the same gates. And before we actually start with looking at what each gate is doing, there is something I want to say, that in order to use and enjoy this module, you don't really have to know about the different functions or what gate will come out of each output. All you have to do is just use it. Experiment and just connect the outputs to what you want to trigger and see if you like it. Like I said, this module is capable of introducing interesting and unique rhythms and sounds to your patches, so do yourself a favor and start using it. If you would anyway like to know what each logic gate is doing, then we will go through it now, and if not, just jump to the examples and see for yourselves why it's so cool. So, in the case of the Boolean logic module from Hetrick CV, we have 3 inputs and 6 outputs, and usually we will connect some sort of triggers or gates to the inputs, doesn't have to be to all 3 at once, by the way, and from the outputs we will get the outcome of the different logic functions. Let's dive right in and listen to how each output sounds like. I have clocked from Impromptu Modular, and we have, for now, 2 clock outputs connected to the logic module, 1 our main clock, and another one multiplied by 2.5. I also have the main clock triggering a kick drum, and the multiplied clock triggering a hi-hat, so we can also hear it and compare it to the signal coming out of the different gate outputs, which will trigger a snare drum. And like I said, let's start by listening first to all the different outputs, and then we will go one by one and see exactly what's going on, and also connect a third clock to get even more interesting results. So, this is the kick drum, our main clock. And this is the hi-hat, the multiplied clock. And let's start listening to the different outputs. Okay, so let's go one by one and see what each logic gate is doing, and let's start with the first output, the OR output. Out of the OR output, we will get a signal whenever one or both inputs are active, so in this case it will be whenever the main clock or the multiplied clock or both are sending a signal to the respective inputs, and let's listen to how this sounds like. Let's move on to the AND output. Out of the AND output, we will get a signal whenever all inputs are active, and in this case we have just 2 connected, so just when input A and input B receive a signal, we will get a signal out of the AND output. Let's listen to this. Now, out of the XOR gate, or the exclusive OR gate, we will get a signal whenever input A or input B are active, but unlike the normal OR gate, Here we will not receive a signal when both are active, only when A or B are active. Let's move on to the NOR gate, which is the opposite of the OR gate. Out of the NOR output, we will receive a signal whenever all inputs are inactive, so only when there is no signal coming in both input A and input B. The NAND gate or the NOT AND gate is the opposite of the AND gate, so from the NAND gate we will receive a signal whenever both inputs are inactive or when only one of the inputs is active, so when input A is active or when input B is active or when both are inactive. And we have one last gate, the XNOR gate or the exclusive NOR gate. Out of the XNOR output, we will receive a signal whenever both inputs are active or when both are inactive. Okay, so those were all the different logic gates, and now, just for fun, before we look at a few examples, let's connect a third clock to input C and listen to all the different outputs. Very nice. Let's look now at a few examples. Okay, so here we have two Boolean logic modules, and let's start with this one here. It receives two different clocks from the main clock, and the OR output drives one FM operator, and the AND output drives the second FM operator. The feedback amount of both FM operators is being modulated by the 8FO from Bog Audio. They are panned hard left and hard right in the mixer, and I'm using triggers from AS to mute and unmute them. Let's listen to how they sound like. So you could hear the different rhythms they have, and because the 8FO is modulating their feedback amount with different phases of the LFO, we get a nice stereo effect moving the sound from left to right. The third output of this logic module is driving the hi-hat section of tremor, but we will get to this later on. We have the second logic module, it's also receiving two different clocks from the main clock, and its first three outputs are driving the trigger, accent and open hi-hat triggers of the hi-hat module from Hora, and the other three outputs drive a bass drum module, a snare module and a rimshot module, also from Hora. Again, I'm using triggers from AS to mute and unmute the different drum channels. Let's listen to how the drums sound like and add also the FM operators. It sounds a bit crazy and like it's not sitting together, but for this we have tremor to add a nice stable kick drum. It's receiving a trigger from the main clock, and like we've seen before, its hi-hat section is being triggered by the third output of the logic module. We also have a base coming from the Even VCO. It's receiving pitch information from the grid sequencer, which is then going through slop to add even more movement to the sound. The sawtooth wave coming out of the Even VCO is going through tangents, and the cutoff point of tangents is also being modulated by the 8FO. So let's start adding the different voices and listen to the interesting rhythms we get. So here we have four Boolean logic modules, two of them create different rhythms, and two are actually receiving audio signals, turning them to something raw and gritty. And let's start with the first voice, which is coming from two FM operators. They receive pitch information from the grid sequencer, once directly and once through the pitch tools module from 21 kHz, so it's tuned a few octaves lower. The first logic module received two different clocks from the main clock, and its OR and XOR outputs drive the FM operators. Both oscillators go then to another logic module, and from there to two tangents filters. Now, the logic module is doing the same thing with the audio signals as with the signals coming out of the clock, so what we get is a much grittier sound full of dust and sand. Both cutoff points of the filters are being modulated by the twin quartet from Hora, and let's listen to how this sounds like. You could hear the sound the logic module gave the FM operators and also the interesting rhythm they got. Another voice is coming from Chebyshev by Squinky Labs. It's receiving pitch information from another grid sequencer. And also here we have a Boolean logic module, but this time it sends all six outputs to the sequential switch. And from there, it's triggering the ADSR module from Bog Audio, and this ADSR module is controlling the envelope of Chebyshev. The sequential switch is being triggered by another grid sequencer, and let's listen to how this sounds like, and add also the sound from the FM operators. Again, you could hear the different rhythms and how they changed according to the sequential switch. Another voice is coming from the functional VCO, also from Squinky Labs, and it's also receiving pitch information from another grid sequencer, and this time it's sending three different waveforms to the three inputs of the logic module, a sine wave, a triangle wave, and a square wave. And the pulse width of the square wave is also modulated by the twin quartet. The OR output of the logic module is going through the frequency shifter, also from Squinky Labs, and also here the twin quartet is modulating its range through a VCA. We have again a bass coming from the Even VCO, it's receiving pitch information from yet another grid sequencer, and it's going through tangents. Let's listen to the sound coming out of the functional VCO, and then add all the rest. Thank you. Okay guys, and that was it. Next time you start a patch, just add a Boolean logic module, doesn't have to be this one from Hetrick CV, and see how many interesting rhythms and sounds you can add to your patch. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.